program of the first group flight incorporated the photographing by the astronauts of themselves in their cabin. This is what weightlessness is like. Watch him in this state of weightlessness. See him blink and leap. Conduct scientific observations. Talk by radio with the Earth and with his space twin. Unbuttoning himself, the astronaut attempts to float in this state of weightlessness. As I look at Mother Earth, I cannot get my fill before it enters in his body. And my heart fills with a fervent desire to save this planet of ours from an atomic death. Soon they will return home. People alive has flown already more than 2.5 million kilometers. Popovich, meanwhile, has covered some 2 million kilometers. I'm feeling fine, and I'm ready to make the descent. I'm very happy that everything's going well with you. I suggest you do some exercises to limber up. And indeed, after the protracted state of weightlessness, one must prepare oneself for overloads again. Meanwhile, Mother Earth prepares to meet the space hero. At the Coordinating Computing Center, scientists embark upon strenuous preparations for a thing that has never been done before. The simultaneous landing of 2 spaceships. The ships have to land near Karaganda in Kazakhstan. The ships descend. Like meteors, they dive into the denser layers of the atmosphere. Tornado of fire roars outside the porthole. Goodbye, Cosmos. The astronauts catapult out. The parachute down. Mother Earth welcomes back its son. Home again. The astronaut has already radioed his bearings. The ground here is rocky and desolate and covered with bitter wormwood. Nevertheless, how fine it is to be back on solid ground again. There he is. His friends and comrades run up. Everybody wants to know how he feels. And of course, autographs are demanded. These hastily written lines will certainly be a precious relic. How pleasant it is to take a few steps and inhale the air of the space. They greet you, Earth people, and jubilant, the Earth people greet the astronauts. From now on, space seems still nearer. In Karaganda, just as they had promised before they took off. Popovich has already had a shave, but Nikolaev seems to regret parting with his beard. After all, it is also a souvenir of space. They went up for the sake of the people of the Earth, for the sake of their present and future, and the Earth people eagerly hang on their lips. They're wanted on the telephone. Is that coming, Nikolaev? Can you hear me? I'm very glad and proud. I greet you and express my admiration. I really do not know what other words I could use to express my feelings. Thank you very much, Nikita Sergeyevich. I greet you, Comrade Popovich. I'm glad to hear such a cheerful voice and also your declaration that you are feeling fine and are prepared to carry out any assignment that the government may give you. I congratulate you and wish you the best of health. Thank you very much, Nikita Sergeyevich. After all these experiences, the astronauts think they might take a nap. But they are too excited to sleep long. Popovich is brimming with impressions and seeks to chat without end with his friend about space and the moon, about life in the state of weightlessness, and about the future. Then they also want to know about all that had happened on Earth when they were up in space. Lenin lives in their heart. He had his picture with him up in space. Crowds line the board with thanks to welcome the heroes of the space age. The space twins are in Gigolini on the Volga. The world is anxious for news, and here they give their first press conference. The group flight, which lasted several days, has shown that man can live and work in space for a long time. In 95 hours, Nikolai circled the Earth 64 times, while in the 71 hours he was up in space, Popovich made 48 circuits. The doctors have completed their examinations, and now the two spacemen will fly to Moscow by different planes. The time being, they pass. Until we meet again, and again, up they go. The space menu was good, but the ordinary Earth dinner is much more appetizing. Take over the joystick. They are so eager to fly that they are prepared even now to take off for the stars again. Moscow awaits them. Vnukovo has become the gateway to the grand welcomes given to the heroes from space. Khrushchev has interrupted his holiday and has flown back from down south. Here they come. With a fighter escort of honor, the plane circles above the Soviet capital in greeting. The last few seconds are full of suspense. Lies the red carpet of the astronauts. First he said it was Yuri Gagarin. Next came German Titov. Now there are two of them at once, Andrei Nikolaev and Pavel Popovich. Tell Nikita Khrushchev that the assignment given them by the government has been carried out. They are ready to fulfill their country's every command. What a great and happy day! This is the third Moscow is welcoming back the victors of space. This is the third time jubilant crowds fill Lenin Avenue, that avenue of glory. Today, they are the darlings of everyone, the idols of all. They were here when they bid farewell to Moscow. Andrea Nikolaev speaks. Dear friends, allow me to express most heartfelt gratitude to the Central Committee of the Communist Party, the Soviet government, and to Nikita Khrushchev for having bred and trained the great friendly family of Soviet astronauts, those loyal sons of our multinational motherland. It is my good fortune with Andrian Nikolaev to continue the course begun last year by my friends Yuri Gagarin and German Titov. But I must frankly confess, we had it much easier than the first Soviet astronauts. They each went up into space by themselves. We went up together. And when you know you have a friend at your elbow, the feeling is quite different. Nikita Khrushchev made a long speech in which he said in part, the Soviet space heroes are men from the depths of the people. Men infinitely devoted to the cause of communism. It is very noteworthy that among the space brothers we see represented today the various nationalities of our country, Russian, Ukrainian, and Chuvash. We are sure that in the future the family of astronauts will be joined by more sons and daughters of the peoples of our multinational state. The people glorify the space heroes and the scientists, the designers, engineers, and workers who created the spaceship. How logical it is and natural for cosmic conquest to be celebrated here on Red Square, but every year, the Soviet people mark the birthday of the world's first socialist state, a land which is today the great launching pad for Soviet spaceships. Step by step, Soviet science is breaking through into the universe for the sake of peace and human welfare. From Red Square, the heroes go to a reception at the Kremlin. Here, the heavenly brothers receive the gold stars of hero of the Soviet Union. Nikita Khrushchev is the best friend of the astronauts. They look upon him as their space father. He has done so much for astronautics. He has reared a fine family of intrepid spacemen who are prepared to carry out any assignment their country may command them to fulfill. And there involuntarily come to mind Khrushchev's words, we are sure that in the future, a family of astronauts will be joined by more sons and daughters of our multinational state.